Detroit Grand Prix.
Attention at Riverside, the 9:09 a.m. train to Stamford is estimated to arrive at 9:16 a.m. Repeat, the 9:09 a.m. train to Stamford is estimated to arrive
Atlanta.
At 9:16
a.m. Lululemon!
You didn't say it out loud, but if you heard that sound, you know what time it is, race fanners. Robbie here, along with Charlie, my
hey
friend.
Guys.
And as you can see here, we are on our way to the 2024 New York Auto Show. Moving us by Metro North.
Yeah. By the way, this is not sponsored. We are not sponsored.
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure another train went around there. We'll see you in the city.
Yeah.
And we're at the show. And we're on the main floor looking to go to Camp Jeep. And as you can see, Nissan and Ford at the show too, and we're looking at the map.
Yeah, Ford is right there.
Ford's booth is right there. Same place as the off-rodeo, which we might see later today. So Charlie...
Robert, can you buy me a Ford Bronco?
Well, I can tell you about Charlotte a Ford Bronco because that's one of her dream cars. The new Santa Cruz is there. We're going to check that out. Along with the new Tucson, which also revealed at the show.
What do you think is going to happen? Hey, guys.
There's Charlie again. And the new Nissan Kicks and a slew of new stuff from Genesis will also be here.
Yeah, and of course, Ford Off-Rodeo.
The Bronco Off-Rodeo is going to be there. Hopefully the new Mustang GTD will be there.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but I really want a Ford.
Oh, is that? Yeah, that is the off-rodeo.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
So, sit rep, we are here at the Ford off-rodeo, the Bronco off-rodeo. And look at that Bronco Raptor go by.
This is gonna be fun.
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure last year they took the slot of the Toyota Thrill Ride.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure the Bronco and the Bronco Sport will be there too.
Ford.
Because I've had it mine.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a sick car, isn't it?
So that's the, one of the Broncos. Bronco Raptors there, we confirmed that.
Sick, cool, isn't it?
I wonder if the Bronco Sport is going to be in the show too. Or in the ride, I mean. And they have the obstacles right there. Mint. Kudos to Ford for bringing it over here. Oh yes, and here's the Bronco Raptor. But Charlie, look at the angle that Bronco's going over.
Yeah, that's a pretty steep angle.
But these are built for that sort of off-roading. Battling Jeep Wranglers. Also, a bit of a diss track for, since we're at Ford, since Jeep can't hear us. Jeep is the only Chrysler, aka Stellantis brand here. Probably the reason why is that Well, probably the reason why is that some fans, and including yours truly, are not that too big of a fan of Chrysler's EV strategy. Feet, the new Dodge Charger.
So, for the record, I have to agree with you on it because, I mean, hold on. Like, what's Chrysler trying to do?
Well, they're saying they want to be better, like, with the environment, but isn't every other car company doing that and doing it at a better way?
Feet
Toyota. Thank you, Toyota, for your strategy at the show this year, or yeah, with your cars.
We love Toyota.
Thank you, Joe Gibbs Racing.
Yep. And Christopher Bell.
And Denny Hamlin. And Martin Truex Jr. And maybe Ty Gibbs.
Okay, that's funny.
That's sick.
Yeah, and I think right next door, that is Cam T, ladies and gentlemen.
It's cold out here.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Baby, look at that building they're building.
There's a gladiator right there.
A gladiator?
Yeah.
That's incredible, isn't it?
And of course the Wrangler 4xe is there. And who knows if the 392 might be back for possibly their final model year.
Yeah. All the way up.
This is going to be incredibly fun, isn't it?
There's enough pop. Don't they? Are they entering from both sides?
No, they're not. It doesn't seem that way.
Concrete.
They have to put a building on it.
So, Charlie.
So basically, Jeep and Ford are completely different sets.
Obviously.
Yeah. So they don't enter from the same side. It's different.
Yeah. Which is a quick question, like, what's the car you would like to see the most at the show this year?
I'm not sure, to be honest, but, the Subaru. I like to see Subaru.
I see Subaru?
Yeah, my dad, my grandma, my mom all have a Subaru.
Yeah. Well, I like to see what Ford or Chevy's offering. Also, if, early in the video, Hyundai, Kia, and Genesis.
Yeah. This is going to get very interesting.
Yeah. And as you can see here, here's the a closer look at Camp Jeep. Yeah.
This is going to be so fun. Off-roadio, I like that. Off-roadio.
You know that we are right in the middle of the two rides.
Yeah, we are right in the middle. Right slap dab in the center. As they would say in Australia.
I think Jeep has more cars, so the line goes faster.
Yeah, that's true.
Ford has more space.
Yeah, that's a fair point.
This is so nice.
Oh, I agree. Oh, we are going to have a very fun time.
Oh, yeah.
Very fun and interesting time.
And that's the sound of Chrysler.
Oh yeah, Chrysler.
So which boys and girls, vehicles do you want to ride in?
The Bronco Raptor.
Inside, yeah. Robert.
Oh, the EV test track?
Yeah.
I don't know, I wonder what's at the EV test track. Maybe the EV6 might be there? Kia.
Oh, Kia!
Kia's there.
They have these people, Nissan, Chevy,
Kia.
The Mach-E will be there too, I believe.
Oh, Cadillac. Let's do Cadillac.
I'm pretty sure the Lyric might be there too.
Hey, Robert, can we do Cadillac?
Yeah, sure.
Chevy and Cadillac.
Chevy and Cadillac, and the boat will be there.
The person who brought a winter coat. I'm right. I was so.
Yeah.
I'm fine. Yeah, let him know that everything is okay. I don't know what he's gonna say, but hopefully something not.
Oh, yes, they are. What do we have? One, two cars.
Way better than I am because I'm not professional.
I might be semi-professional.
I'm not even professional, but I don't know.
You're a professional for snapping minutes, and I can tell you that.
Oh! Did you really say that?
Said that out loud, didn't I?
Did you actually said it out loud? I could get you for that.
Please don't.
I won't.
So, wait, we have like two cars that are at the loading area.
So far.
I don't know, we're gonna have like three or four cars if the Raptors arrive.
Yeah. We're gonna have fun.
So those guys are rolling out and we're gonna roll in.
Yeah.
Two Raptors are ready to roll. That's a tough question. No need for a fix or a repair daily.
So tell me why we waited so long.
Because it's cool looking.
Yeah.
I asked him why are we waiting for the
room. Oh, yeah. Because it's the top of the line.
It's one of the best off-roaders there are. The Bronco Sport, or? Wait, the media? Who knows, maybe Motortron might be there too.
You know, it's obviously
somebody got the line.
Yeah, so which Bronco are we in here?
So we actually own Bronco Badlands. This is the Bronco Badlands with the Sasquatch package.
Okay.
Oh, the Sasquatch package.
Yes. So this is actually like it's fully loaded and everything. And the amazing part about it too, you know, it comes with all of my hair switches over here. And on top of that too.
Gold modes.
Yeah, so all the
speaking of which.
So we can actually start off with, right now I'm on slippery mode. So I'm gonna start off with my rear locker and you can see my equipment.
Locking
locker.
Diff, yep. And
we're gonna be driving this smoothly over here.
Oh my gosh.
And it's crazy
how like
you can be able to drive through over here.
Oh my goodness.
So it's really, really crazy how like this
yeah.
is a 21.
And it's really stable even on this grid.
It's 21. So the NASCAR track at Daytona is 29.
Oh,
degrees of banking.
And this dude can be able to bank it 29 degrees.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That one I can definitely tell you.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And on top of that too, like this also with the GoPro settings right now, I'm gonna put it down to rock raw mode.
Rock rolling.
Yeah, so the rock roll mode, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this down to neutral, switch it from slippery mode, which is on full auto, down to rock roll mode, which is gonna be taking it from full auto down to four low, and then automatically gives me my rear lockers and my stay bar disconnect.
And it gives you your cameras too.
Yes, I am. So now you can actually use it from, you can see your front tires as you're doing.
Look at that.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
So now what I am going to do is I'm going to balance this thing on three wheels. And the good thing
is. Three-wheeling.
Mm-hmm. We're going to be three-wheeling over here. So it's going to be really, really nice and smooth. Over
oh,
here.
Yeah.
And then once we get right about here, that right rear tire is pretty much in the air. So we just
look at that.
On three wheels.
Oh, wow.
So now I'm going to slowly bring that right rear tire back down. And now we're just gonna be like teeter-tottering all over the place, right?
Yeah.
Now watch this.
Oh
that's
my
the
God.
Stay bar disconnect, so it actually like stabilizes the vehicle as you're driving through the trails too. So it's really, really insane.
Look at that.
That's
yeah.
really cool.
So what's the horsepower on this thing?
It's actually a 330 horsepower with a twin turbo.
Are that EcoBoost?
Yes, it is EcoBoost.
Nice.
That's cool.
Now on top of that too, we're about to actually climb up this good old mountain, which
wait
is a
for it.
Degree incline over here.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go ahead and align myself over here.
And what is the max angle that this thing can climb?
It depends on the variables, but close to like around 58 degrees.
Yeah. So piece of cake.
At this point, like, you know, it's gonna be sloshing. Like,
there we go.
You know, this is like a good old breathing kind over here.
Oh, that's
really
crazy.
Thank you. We're even higher than the streets of New York right now.
So oh, yeah, we can see so Manhattan. Cool. Look at that.
So, and on top of that, too, what I can do is I can even, like, drive here very, very smoothly. And it's crazy, too, because you can even...
Locking
diffs.
That's good. Look at that.
There it is.
That was fun.
And I go get him, brothers.
Got some more. So now what I am gonna do is I'm gonna put this down to neutral, and then I will switch it all the way back to slippery mode because I have 8 go mode settings.
Okay.
And then once that does that, it's the only time whenever I gotta put it on neutral, get it in and out of 4 low. But the rest of the modes, you can be able to do it. And what's cool is
on
like,
the fly, right?
On the fly.
On the fly.
And on top of that, you can even enjoy like through this streets of New York.
That's awesome ride.
About like driving a Bronco too, you can actually sign up for the Bronco Off Rodeo where you can actually get a good 4 steps. So.
Alright, thanks so much, man.
Thank you guys for having me.
Yeah, it's definitely built for it, Proud. And that was our ride over here. Oh yeah, it was. I'm ready for the next adventure. This was the Sasquatch. And now we're at Camp Jeep. And probably the same setup as we did last year. And I bet they have some cars displayed here too. And turns out since we're now here, might as well see what Ford's Crosstown rivals are doing. No, it turns out that they have this ramp the other way around. Four by E. And did you see the other cars on display? There's like a Grand Cherokee 4xE there too. And then Gladiators do too. Another 4xE. I wonder when they're gonna reveal the production Recon or the new Wagoneer S, because those cars are coming soon. And 392. One, two, three. So here we are at the loading area. I think we're in this Gladiator.
What?
Oh, snap.
Oh, are you serious?
You're throwing shade at Ford, aren't you?
Huh?
You're throwing shade at Ford, aren't you?
I'm good.
We're
good to go. So we're in the Gladiator, right?
Yep, you are in the Gladiator.
Yeah. The Gladiator,
right, how
Rubicon.
Much horsepower does this thing have?
This is only at like 285 or something. This is a V6. But this vehicle is kind of heavy. Like, if there was a V6 in the car, you're probably looking at, like, 350 or something.
Yeah,
but
this is a big old truck.
Yeah, you got a big old truck, so you're only looking at, like,
285 horsepower. 285 horsepower. Yeah. Up our first hill.
You'll notice this is uneven.
Oh, I noticed that.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Look at that. And this is banking.
Yeah, I got a button. Oh, I don't know where mine is.
Woo!
Banking.
So if we go sideways, point.
Banking.
How far can you go?
Yeah, I don't know. They're not liable. Can you go do it?
Yeah.
Leaps it.
Yeah. Well. More uneven terrain.
Yep, uneven terrain.
Yeah.
Control sway bar is disconnected, so it allows all the tires to be flat.
Oh. And what's the ground clearance on the Gladiator?
How can I explain the sway bar? The sway bar is like your axle, right?
And sway bars.
And it can collapse.
I know that this is a
because
truck.
Control on, you
gotta look at the bed.
So that it can
they can make a 4xe.
So anytime that tire will go down more to have ground surface or that tire wheel, that's basically what it goes. And then way up in the sky, this is 40 degrees up.
40 degree angle, yeah. Same as Ford. The Bronco can do it. Let's see if this can do it better.
The Bronco can do it.
Yeah.
Here we go, up the hill.
I bet this can do it better. Here we go. There we go.
You have to do this all day long. You're a hero.
Thank you.
And down we go.
Wow.
Look at that.
Oh my goodness.
That's awesome, man.
That was fun.
That's amazing.
Jeep's a natural, this. Yeah. Thanks for the ride, man. Oh, that's
Yeah, man, of course. Thanks for coming by. And the next one right over there.
Yeah.